This is Dana Susan Beasley of angelarts.biz, and I'm continuing the series on falling in love with the bridegroom. Before I get started, if you would like to get my complete falling in love with the bridegroom devotional for free, check the link in the description below. This devotional will teach you how to have quiet times and give you ample scriptures to spend in devoted study with our Lord. Now let's get to today's devotional, and I'm going to start it. Lord Jesus, I thank you that we have a destiny, and that is the marriage supper of the Lamb. And thank you for giving us that invitation, and help us to joyfully accept it and to wear the clothes of your righteousness. And it's in your precious name I pray. Amen. Now I'm going to read from Matthew 22, 1 through 14. I did this a while ago, but for some reason I studied this passage twice and wrote about it twice. So I think maybe it's kind of important, and I'm going to read it again. All right, so I'm going to read Matthew 22, 1 through 14, and that is the English Standard Version that I'm reading from. Friends, this is the word of the Lord. And again, Jesus spoke to them in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son and sent his servants to call those who were invited to the wedding feast. But they would not come. Again, he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those who are invited, see how I have prepared my dinner, my oxen and my fat calves have been slaughtered, and everything is ready. Come to the wedding feast.' But they paid no attention and went off, one to his farm, another to his business, while the rest seized his servants, treated them shamefully, and killed them. The king was angry, and he sent his troops and destroyed those murderers and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The wedding feast is ready, but those invited were not worthy. Go therefore to the main roads and invite him to the wedding feast, as many as you find.' And those servants went out into the roads and gathered all whom they found, both bad and good. So the wedding hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to look at the guests, he saw there a man who had no wedding garment. And he said to him, 'Friend, how did you get in here without a wedding garment?' And he was speechless. Then the king said to the attendants, 'Bind him hand and foot and cast him into the outer darkness. In that place, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen.'" This is a pretty challenging passage, and I don't remember all the details, but I know that there are some pretty cute cultural things in here about the wedding garment that would bear some further study. I know I did that a while back, but anyway, it would be interesting to look that up again. But here is what I gleaned from this, that our bridegroom, Jesus, is like. He invites everyone to the wedding feast of the marriage supper of the Lamb, but many ignore him. They get busy doing their own things. Some of those outright kill the servants and messengers sent to invite people. And of course, the parable is talking about the Old Testament prophets that were killed. But the bridegroom's father keeps sending until all have been invited. He calls both the wicked and the righteous, those overlooked by society, and the party crashers he throws into the outer darkness. That's the one that didn't have the right wedding garment. What is my response? So I have accepted this invitation, and I want to be a messenger inviting others in. Am I ready to pay the cost? I can expect to get beat up. Interesting, right? So that is what these people happen to. This is what happened to the servants of the king. They were treated shamefully and killed. But God wants the invitation to everyone. So am I willing to take that message? Even though I might not get killed over here in America yet, but I might be rejected. I might be made fun of. I might be scorned, I might be called all sorts of things, but am I willing to risk that, to invite people to the important marriage supper of the Lamb? It really makes you think. So, what was God saying to me as I meditated? He will guide me out of some pretty hard times I was going through at that time. And, you know, life goes on and more challenges come, and I have a ton of them. So I just have to trust that He will guide me out of those. So that is my devotional for today. I'm going to end in prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, give us courage and boldness to invite others into this party and to give them the right garment, which, you know, thinking about it, is the garment of the blood of Christ, who died on a cross for us and who rose for us on the third day. That is garment, the garment that we need to be invited into this wedding feast. And so help us as we spread the good news to those who don't know You, and help us to do that no matter what the cost, and show us what that means for us, each of us, in our individual lives, which are all so vastly different. Just show us our destinies and bring us those people that need to know You, and give us the courage to invite them. And it's in Your precious name I pray. Amen. All right, so that's all for today's devotional. Tomorrow I'll continue my series on falling in love with the bridegroom. Again, if you want the free devotional, check the link below. Would you like to go deeper with the scriptures? Find out how to study the Bible and find out more about my Becoming God's Bride Bible study. Check that out also in the description box below. So with that, I'm going to leave you with my favorite blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. This is Dana Susan Beasley of AngelArts.biz. Together, may we reach new heights in our lives and beyond.